So continuing from the 165th problem, so here the axis is inclined to VP at 40 degrees. The axis is inclined to VP, appears to be inclined to VP at 40 degrees. So now since he says it is appears, so he has given the apparent inclination. Since he has given the apparent inclination, now here in the second position top view, we have to see the axis now. What will be the position of the axis with respect to HP? So since the axis is inclined to HP at 45 degrees, as it is resting on one of the base edges, which is PU, so the axis is, once the axis is inclined to HP, so you will going to get the apparent length here, O over 1. But the inclination given is also appears to be, so appears means always he has given the apparent inclination. So that means we are rewriting the second position top view here directly by rotating at an angle of 40 degrees to VP. Since because this inclination is apparent apparent length and this also inclination given is apparent inclination, so we can rewrite the same sketch here by rotating at an angle of 40 degrees. So how to do that, how to transfer all these things which you need to do it. So consider any point here and draw a horizontal line which is parallel to XY, and then by using the protractor you measure an angle of 40 degree with respect to VP and then draw an inclined line. Then you measure the length from O to O1. From O you cut an arc on this to get this point O1. So from O1 you draw, since QT is perpendicular to O1, so from here you measure an angle of 90 degree with respect to O1 and then draw an inclined line which is a perpendicular line. Then measure the length from O1 to Q, from O1 to Q and O1 to T, and you transfer that onto this side with O1 to P and also O1 to T to get this point QT. Once you get these two points, then from O1, from O you measure the distance from O to this point which is PU, to the intersection of PU line. So you get this point, from here transfer it onto this. Then again from here you measure the distance from O to this point, from O you cut it here. Then by using the protractor, using this point, you measure an angle of 90 degree with respect to the O1 line and draw a perpendicular. Similarly on this also you measure the distance of you measure an angle of 90 degree with respect to O1 and draw a perpendicular line. Then by using the compass, you measure the distance from this point to P and also from this point to U. All these four points will going to have the same distance. From this point you transfer it on this side, and also from this point you transfer it on this side to get this point P and C respectively. Similarly from this point you cut it on this side, you will going to get this point U, and from this point you will going to cut it on this side, you will going to get the point D. Now similarly from O you draw a from O, since BE is perpendicular to since BE is perpendicular to O1 line, so from O you measure an angle of 90 degree with respect to the O1 line and then draw a perpendicular line. Then by using the compass, you measure the distance from O to B and also from O to E, both will have same distances. From O you transfer it on this side, you will get the point B, and from O you transfer it on this side, you will going to get this point E. Now since we have the point C and D, so through CD line you measure a perpendicular line, and you draw a through CD, since AC and FD are perpendicular to CD, so from CD you measuring by using the compass, by using the protractor you measure an angle of 90 degree with respect to CD, and also from the point D also you measure the angle of 90 degree with respect to CD and then draw a perpendicular line. Then from C you measure the distance from C to A, which is equal to D to F. From C you transfer it on this side, you will going to get the point A. Then with D as center, from D you cut an arc on this side, you are going to get the point F. So name them A B C D E F O, A B C D E F O, and similarly P Q R S. And here we need to transfer from R and S. So to do that, from P you draw a perpendicular, and also from U you draw a perpendicular with respect to PU. Then from P to R, you measure the distance. From P, you cut an arc on this side. You will going to get this point R. And also from U, you cut an arc on this. You are going to get the point S. So once you get this, then you join PQ, R, S, T, U, and then P. Then join between AP, BQ, and you complete the entire views, including the visible and invisible edges, as it is given in the second position top view. The same thing you should be repeated here on this third position top view, including the visible and invisible edges. Now we need to write the front view. Since we need to write the front view, so you project, draw a horizontal projector from A dash F dash and draw a vertical projector from A and F to intersect at these two points, A dash and F dash. Draw a horizontal projector from B dash, E dash and O dash and draw a vertical projector from B, E and O to intersect at these three points, that is B dash, O dash and E dash. Similarly, draw a horizontal projector from C dash, D dash and draw a vertical projector from C and D to intersect at C dash, D dash. And then similarly, draw a horizontal projector from P and P dash and U dash and draw a vertical projector from P and U to intersect at P dash, U dash. And similarly, draw a horizontal projector from Q dash, T dash and O1 dash and draw a vertical projector from Q to intersect at Q dash and from O1 to intersect at O1 dash and T to intersect at T dash. And then draw a horizontal projector from R dash and S dash and draw a vertical projector from R and S to intersect at R dash S dash. Then name them A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash, E dash, F dash and O dash. Similarly, P dash, Q dash, R dash, S dash, T dash and U dash and O1 dash. Then join with a continuous thin line A dash to B dash to C dash to D dash to E dash to F dash and F dash to A dash. Similarly, P dash to Q dash to R dash to S dash to T dash and T dash to U dash and U dash to P dash with a continuous thin line. Then join between A dash to P dash, B dash to Q dash, C dash to R dash, E dash to S dash, E dash to T dash and F dash to U dash. So all these things you should join by means of the continuous thin lines. Then we apply the boundary conditions, condition of visibility. So all the exterior edges of the boundaries of the solids are visible. Join between AP, A dash, P dash, P dash, U dash, U dash, T dash, S dash, S dash, D dash, C dash, B dash and B dash, A dash. All these things will going to form the exterior edges of the boundaries of the solids. Oh, that becomes, it is visible. So you dark them continuously. Then when you look from the front view, PQ, RS, T, U, A, P will going to become visible. So when you look from the front view, PQ, RS, T, that is the base is near the observer. So it is visible. So P dash to Q dash to R dash and R dash to S dash, you dark them. So from Q dash, P dash, Q dash and Q dash, R dash is visible. Therefore, B dash, Q dash also becomes visible because from a point, if any one of the edges is visible, then automatically all other edges emanating from that edge, from that point will be visible. So apply that condition. So that becomes visible. Similarly, the same condition is applied here also from R dash edges is visible, R dash, Q dash is visible. Therefore, C dash, R dash is visible. So now we have to write the other conditions. Since A dash F dash is crossing the edge B dash Q dash, so B dash Q dash is visible, therefore A dash F dash becomes invisible. Similarly, similarly with respect to the C dash also, so from F dash, so Q dash R dash is crossing, so F dash U dash is crossing the edge Q dash R dash is visible, therefore F dash U dash is invisible. Similarly, S dash T dash, sorry, E dash T dash is crossing the visible edge of R dash S dash, therefore E dash T dash becomes invisible. So from E dash F dash and E dash T dash is invisible, so E dash T dash becomes invisible. So since the portion of the hexagonal surface, that is A dash F dash, F dash E dash and E dash T dash is invisible, therefore O dash becomes invisible, and since PQRSTU is visible, so O1 dash is becomes visible. Now in the finally, when you check this solution, so since hexagonal prism of 25 mm sides of base with the axis length 50 mm rests on one of its edges of the base, draw its projection when the axis is inclined to HP at 45 degrees and the axis appears to be inclined to VP at 40 degrees. Since we have considered all the conditions of the problem, and hence the problem is right.